Hi, good evening. I am Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram, consultant neonatologist and pediatrician. Welcome to my channel. I would like to thank you for subscribing and turning on notifications. I do request you to share the details of this channel with your friends and colleagues and relatives who might find this beneficial. They don't need to have small children in their family. You share it with them and they might have families they know who might benefit from it. So do spread the word because that will really help. And in terms of going through the channel, I had mentioned that you go through playlists. So please go through the playlists because there are a number of videos now and you may be confused looking at the list alone. So go through the playlist and you can go look at the title and that will tell you if it's for parents or for medics. And obviously if it's for parents, you have the appropriate topic, for example, feeding related or life support related for kids under 1 year and for general parent advice as well. So in this video, I'm going to share very important information that every parent should know about using the infant car seats. So before we go into the details of the car seat itself, I would try to stress on safety, and seat belts also are not universally being used in the developing world. Always look at your friends, your colleagues, your relatives when you go in the cars, encourage them. The driver seat belts are now universally applicable, but the passenger or the rear seat belts are not used as often, and many people use it as a way to avoid fines rather than as a way to protect themselves. So please educate your family about the importance of seat belts in the first place, because the car seats come as an extension of that for children. So wearing seat belts, it's not just for the driver, it's for the passenger, it's for the rear passengers as well. And remember that when an accident happens, it's in a very brief second that such issues happen. We cannot predict. There is no way of saying that I've not had an accident for 10 years, I won't have one tomorrow. If you are unfortunate enough to be involved in an accident, be secure. I mean, get as best a car as you can with the safety features like airbags, and also make sure you're wearing the seat belt. And in the case of your child, make sure you use appropriate car seat. So why should we use car seats? So it's very important to prevent the infant or the kid being seriously injured in accidents. So you don't need to hit someone. Even if you have a sudden break, it could cause the child to be thrown off the seat. They could fall into the front seat, or they would fall out of the car even. So it could cause serious injury. Many countries, including the UAE and the other developed world, have fines for the drivers if the child is not in a car seat or appropriately secured. The car seats ensure that the child is protected by the seat belts, because a seat belt cannot be used for an infant or child. And using the appropriate car seat is important, as it's giving vaccines to your child. We worry about vaccines. Majority of the parents give their child appropriate vaccines to protect them from potential harm. So vaccines are a form of protecting them from possible harm, and the car seat is the same. So harm could happen in the form of acquiring an infection at any time, and that's why we are giving them the vaccine to be protected against it if they do get exposed. Similarly, an accident could happen any time, so you do need a car seat to be used to make sure. And as I said earlier, the seat belt is for the same. I've seen friends getting serious injuries or even life-threatening problems from use of failure to use an appropriate seat belt or car seat. So the other important thing is, if you do have children in developing world and you want to take them in a two-wheeler, be very careful. Avoid that as best as you can, because keeping them on a two-wheeler doesn't secure them in any way. Similarly, the mother holding the baby and sitting on the back of a two-wheeler is very insecure, because a bump into the next car may throw them off. It's not worth taking that risk. You can ask for a taxi instead of taking them in a two-wheeler. So there is also an important legislation that children below 13 years of age should not be in the front seat of a car. And this is because majority of the cars have passenger airbags on the front, and during an impact it opens at great force. So an adult can withstand that force, but for a child it may come right on the face, and for the adult it usually comes at the neck or chest level. But if it comes on the face, it blocks their breathing, they may suffocate, or the sudden force may damage them. So if you do have to carry a child in your front seat, for example, if you have just a two seat in the car, or the back seat has to be folded to carry something, you can temporarily disable the passenger airbag if there is no other option, but avoid this situation as for never keep babies in the front seat. So this is to show you how the airbag works. So it comes right on, and if the child is here, the blast will carry right to the face. And this is again showing you how the airbag works. So during a direct front impact, the airbag opens very quickly, and the rapidity of its opening is obviously important to protect you during the impact from hitting the dashboard or the steering. But for a child, the rapidity with which opens may damage them. So we have three different types. We have the infant seats, we have the in-between front-facing seats, and we have the booster seats according to the age of the child. So these are examples of the infant seat, and as you can see, they can be used as a carrier option, and they can fit on a stroller as well, in addition to being in the car. They are not very heavy. They are meant to carry kids up to 16 kilos, so they are designed to be reasonably carryable. If they function as a carrier, you have to carry that weight as well as the baby's weight. So obviously a normal adult should be able to carry them. So they're not heavily designed. Remember that the young infants up to 10 to 12 kilos have to be facing backward. Usually 10 to 12 months of age, they have to be rear facing. The car seat has to be kept in such a way. So remember that the seat belt is strapped onto the car seat, so that's very important. Just keeping the car seat and putting the child on it is not enough. The car seat has to be secured in the car using the seat belt going across the hooks on the back and then strapping into the seat belt slot. So the seat belt is important for the car seat as well. And once a child is there, you should secure the car seat with the straps. And that is important. The same infant car seat can be used front facing once they develop a good neck control and they're heavy enough to sit. So it's usually 10 to 12 kilos that they can be front facing, usually at least 10 months to 1 year of age. So the infant seats fit infants up to 16 kilos, normally up to 3 to 4 years of age if you're growing on the average, but in the heavier infants, it may only last you till they are 2 to 3 years. The infant car seats are convenient as they can double up as strollers, carriers or rockers, and this can be used at home. I have put in my video on infant positioning that you can use this to reduce the chances of head flattening, as well as you could use it to reduce the risk of reflux when the infants are refluxing in the initial phase. Don't leave them in the same position for a long time, but during the daytime when you're awake and looking at the baby, they can be in the seat for half an hour, 1 hour at a time, so on. And as I said, always placed rear facing, where the back of the safety seat will cradle the baby's head, neck and torso. At this age, the child's neck is usually not strong enough to support the head, so obviously a serious risk of whiplash injury if the child is sitting front facing. While they are back facing, usually the impact is towards the front, so the child's head goes backwards and stops with the car seat stopping it. So always keep them rear facing at this age. It's very important to ensure it's correctly fitted, as I said, and when you're newly buying it, you can use the help of the professionals to ensure that you're doing it well. The infant has to be strapped appropriately. You shouldn't have any loose objects on the handle, for example, or in the back of the car. It may fall on the infant when you have a sudden brake, so make sure that part is okay. The shoulder strap should be just below the level of the shoulder in these babies, and the neck should not be dropping forward. So in very small babies, it may be difficult to have this option, so you can remove this cushion at the back temporarily till about when they are around 3 kilos or less in the small babies, especially in the premature baby, so they go a little more inclined so the neck doesn't drop back. So this cushioning, this pad, can be removed temporarily in the very small babies. That's an adaptation, but obviously only for the period when if you are keeping them in this, they come forward and the neck flops. So some neonatal units also do car seat challenges before they send home the premature babies to make sure that the neck position that they have doesn't compromise their oxygenation. We have to tighten the strap after the infant is in the seat by pulling on this, so that's very important as well. A strap which is not tight enough is not going to secure the child adequately. So two important precautions: to get the strap across the seat belt and to fit this strap securely to the infant. The other type of car seat we have is a convertible seat. These can be used even beyond 16 kilos, usually up to 34, 36 kilos of weight. These are heavier, so you can't really carry them around. They don't have the adaptations that you have. And in small infants, they can be kept rear facing. And in the older kids, you can have them front facing. So here we have examples where the younger child is rear facing and the older child is front facing, or as you feel appropriate for that child's needs. So convertible seats are handy because you don't need to change them. Some of them dismantle the buckle part when they grow up, and you can just use it as a booster seat even when they are 5 to 6 years of age and onwards. So one seat is enough from infancy till their older age when they need the booster seat. However, it's very important that you choose the right one, and if you do feel comfortable having the infant seat and then changing to the convertible and then the booster seat, it's fine as well. You do have individual front facing seats as well between the 16 to 34 kilo mark, so you can have the infant seat to start and then change to them. So avoid second hand car seats in general, because if the car had been in an accident, it may affect its function. And the car seats, both the infant and the convertible one, should be in the rear seat only for the reason that I explained earlier. The booster seat is used once a child is older and exceeds the weight limit of the forward facing seat, so 36 kilos or so, and they are used to bring the child's sitting position to a level suitable for the car seat belt. So the car's own seat belt is used. There is no harness in the seat itself, and the child can sit without the booster seat after they have a height of 4'9" or so. So almost like a young adult stage, so 14, 15 years of age. In taller families, you may be able to stop it by 12 to 13 years of age. But in general terms, when you put this seat belt, the lap belt should come at the level of the below the hip at the thigh. It should not come in the lower tummy. And the seat belt strap should be comfortably around the shoulder and not over the neck. So till you reach that level, you do need a booster seat. So carry the booster seat with you. The taxis may have booster seats as well. You may have the option, or if you're renting a car, you can rent a booster seat or a child seat as well. So I hope this is informative enough. So two important learning points. Just like vaccination is important, taking your child in a car seat right from the beginning is very important. Don't take any chance, and obviously educate your friends and family as well. And do subscribe, do keep the notifications on, and I request you to share these as well so others can benefit. So appreciate your watching this, and I hope it helps.